The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 8th Chapter, text number 41, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 21st, 1974, in Mayapur, India.
O Lord of the Universe, Soul of the Universe, O Personality of the Form of the Universe, please therefore sever my tie of affection for my kinsmen, the Pandavas and the Rishis.
Vishyatman Vishyamurte Sakeshume Snehopasamimam Chindi Dhirang Pandusu Vrishnisu. Kunti Devi is omen. As a man has got one family, the omen has got two families. Affection, a man has got affection for one family, but a woman has got affection for two families, father's family and husband's family. Therefore, he specifically mentions Pandusu. Pandusu means husband's family, and Vrishnisu, that is father's family. Krishna's father Vasudev and Vasudev's sister is Kunti Devi. Therefore, she belongs to the Vishnu family, Jadu family, from the father's side, and from the husband's side, she belongs to the Kuru family. Actually, the Pandusu, later on, they became Pandus, because Dhritarashtra wanted to separate them from the Kuru family. Both of them, the Dhritarashtra's family and Pandu's family, both of them belong to the Kuru's family. But because Dhritarashtra was very much anxious to separate the Pandavas, the sons of his younger brother Pandu, from the family, so they were known as Pandavas, and his own sons were known as Kurus. So Kunti is praying. The prayer is very peculiar. What is that peculiar prayer? The prayer is snehopasam idam. Pasam means rope. We are bound up by the ropes of affection to the family. This family or that family, everyone is bound up. Atak grihat chetra sutapta vittai janasya mohoyam. This family combination is maya. Because we all, living entities, we are being washed away by the waves of material nature. Prakita kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvas. So, just like the waves of the river carry so many straws scattered here and there, and sometimes by will, when all these straws meet together in the water. So our meeting, I am the father, you are the son, she is the wife, she is the grandson or she is father, she is in this way, our mixing up in a group of family is exactly like the assembly of some straws in the waves of the river. It has no meaning. Just like the straws, they gather together by the movement of the waves, and again by the movements of waves, the straws are scattered here and there, here and there. Nowadays it is very practical. Just like I am an Indian, I am my family, you are European, you are American, you have got family. But now, where we are from the family? We are scattered. This is practical. We have no more any connection with our father, mother, or children. No. We are now gathered in another group, Krishna Conscious Society. So this is Maya. Janasya mohoyam ahang mame. We gather exactly like the straws, and on account of Maya's influence, we become very much attached. Oh, here is my son, here is my wife, here is my family, here is my... And this is entanglement. Our main business is, in the human form of life, how to get out of this material world. They do not know. They not only create family, but also society, community, nation. In this way, we are embarrassed. The so-called nationalism, socialism, and communism, simply moho. Moho. Exactly the same way as the small that insects under some illusion, moho, they come to the light and sacrifice their life. I have told you many times, we have seen in 1947, partition days, Hindu-Muslim fighting. One party as Hindu, other party as Muslim, they fought and so many died. And after death, there was no distinction who is Hindu or who is Muslim. The municipal men, they gathered together in piles and to throw them somewhere. Exactly the same way. The same insect, they come to the light and die in the morning, and we gather them together and throw in the street. So long the life is there, everyone is thinking, I've got this responsibility, I've got this responsibility, I've got this responsibility. And they're working very, very hard and doing all nonsense. Nunam pramatta kuruti bikarma. Now, somebody is stealing for the sake of family maintenance, doing so many sinful activities. But when they are scattered again by the laws of nature, nobody will be sympathetic to me if I suffer for my own sinful activities. But they do, for the so-called family. They get money, and they, due to affection, first of all, whatever he earns by hook or by crook, first of all he wants to see that his wife, children are fed up very nicely, And at last, if there is some remnants, he can eat out of affection, you see. So therefore, this affection is the very hard knot for being bound up in this material world, this affection. Therefore, the Vedic civilization is that the affection is to be cut off compulsory at a certain age. Not that the affection should continue. If the affection continues, then there is no chance of my becoming free from this material world. There is no chance. Therefore, vanaprastha, because the wife's affection with the wife is very, very strong. So vanaprastha means the husband and wife, they give up the affection, not give up, go away from home, and they travel in the holy places just to purify. And again, when the affection draws, they come to the family, again remain for 1 or 2 months, then again go away. So the wife, there is no sex connection, but wife remains as assistant to the man to be accustomed how to remain aloof from the family. And then when he is practiced to remain aloof from the, then wife is also sent back to the family, to the care of elderly children, and the man takes sannyas. Compulsory. It is called civil suicide. My Guru Maharaj used to say, commit civil suicide. If you commit suicide, it is criminal. And it is also suicide. No more connection with family. This is also suicide, but it is civil. There is no criminal action against. But it is also voluntarily committing suicide. No more connection with anyone. Atasav chari ar varnasam dharma niskinchan haiya lai krishnaiko sharam. This is the varnasam dharma. That is material. Varnasam is planned for material life in a systematic way, so that in due course of time, one may give up the family relationship and take sannyas and completely devote for Krishna's service. This is the plan of varnasam. Varnasam dharma is not meant for planning something and you remain in the family. No. The varnasam, varna means Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, Shudra. Chaturvarnam maya sishtam guna karma vibhagas. Guna, not everyone is qualified in the same way. Therefore, the acharya will pick up that they are meant for becoming Brahmins. They are meant for Kshatriyas, or for coming from Kshatriya family, or the Brahmin family. So first of all, these varnas. Then ask the Brahmana, one who is qualified as a Brahmana, he has to observe the 4 ashramas. A Brahmana. The Brahmachari ashram, the Girastha ashram, the Vanaprastha ashram and Sannyas ashram. The Kshatriya, they will have to observe 3 ashramas. Brahmachari, Grihastha and Vanaprastha. And the Vaishyas, 2 ashramas. Brahmachari and Grihastha. And Shudra, only one ashram, only Grihastha. A Shudra is never offered a sannyas. Only the Brahmin is offered. So, in Sankara Sampradaya, strictly, unless one is born in Brahmin family, he is not offered sannyas. He is not given sannyas. So far we are concerned, we also offer sannyas to the Brahmin, not to the Shudras. But according to quality, we create Brahmin. Not that we are offering sannyas to the Shudras, no. The principle is, sannyas can be offered only to the Brahmins. So, one may not mistake that we are offering sannyas to the mlechas, javans, as they complain. Some of my god brothers, they criticize like that. That I am offering sannyas to the mlechas, javans. This is wrong idea. This is naraki buddhi. Actually, a Vaishnava is above this varnasam dharma. But we don't claim that we have become perfect Vaishnava. We are not so impudent. We want to remain under the Vaishnava. Under the Vaishnava. Otherwise, Vaishnava means, in Chaitanya Chaitamrita you'll find, the Vaishnava is Paramahansa. Vaishnava has no saffron cloth. Vaishnava is white cloth. Because Vaishnava is Paramahansa, above. But we don't claim the position of Vaishnava. We want to remain servant of Vishnu. Therefore, sannyas order is below the position of Vishnu. Sannyas order means still in the material classification. But this Vaishnava is paramaninmasaranam satam. Dharma prujhita koita vatra paramaninma. This Vaishnavism is meant for Paramaninmasarana, Paramahansa. Chagunan samatitta etan brahma bhuyaya kalpate. So Vaishnava position is not very easy thing, above all qualities. Therefore, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur introduced not to become an imitation of Rupa Goswami. Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami of Vrindavan, they are Paramahansa. And in Vrindavan you'll find so-called Babajis, they have imitated the dress of Rupa Goswami, half-line cloth, wearing a beedi in the mouth. What is this nonsense? Rupa Goswami used to smoke bidi. Not only that, you'll find in Vrindavan so many Rupa Goswamis are making bidi. Have you seen in the Gopinath Bazar? They're making trade bidis and shameless. Therefore, my Guru Maharaj introduced this. Of course, sannyas is there in the Vaishnava, all the acharyas there, sannyas. But later on, it's so degraded that this biri smoker, ganja smoker, they imitated Rupa Goswami. Therefore, to purify, and Guru Maharaj introduced this sannyas system below the Paramahansas. Not that artificial means I become a Paramahansa. No. When one is The sannyas stage has got four stages. Kutichak, Bahudak, Pribrajakacharya and Paramahansa. Kutichak, when one takes sannyas, these are the processes. He is not practiced to beg from door to door. Therefore, in the beginning, he makes a cottage outside the village, and the foodstuff comes from his home. But he has no connection, because by vanaprastha he has already left home, and by sannyas completely. But takes prasadam from home. That is called kuticha. Then when he's practiced, he goes from door to door, and that is called bahudak. And then, when he's still not practiced, he becomes a preacher, paribrajaka acharya, goes from country to country, state to state for preaching. And after preaching, when the preaching is advanced to some extent, then he sits down in a place as Paramahansa. That is called Paramahansa. Different stages. Not that all of a sudden one becomes Paramahansa and Biri also. Not like that. Paramahansa stage is not to be imitation. So to stop this imitation, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur introduced this system, sannyas. He personally became sannyas, and to many of his disciples he gave sannyas. So the whole process is how to get out of the affection of this family, community, nationality. This is process. This is illusion. But at the present moment, this illusion is being increased. They criticize what is this nonsense? So many people, they have been entrapped by this Krishna consciousness movement, and they are doing nothing for the society, nothing for the nation, nothing for the family. So they are useless, parasite. They are thinking that. Even Subhash Chandra Bose, he was a politician, he came to my Guru Maharaj that so many people, you have captured them, they are doing nothing for nationalism. So Guru Maharaj said, well, for your national propaganda, you require very strong man, but these people are very weak, you can see. They are very skinny. So, don't put your glance upon them. Let them eat something and chant Hare Krishna. He avoided like that. And then there are many others. Then there is a philanthropy to give food to the Daridra Narayan. These things are going on. Nobody is interested that, or they know it, that human life is only meant for God realization. There is no other business. Otherwise, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not so fool that at the age of 24 years, he took sannyas and preached this cult, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Iva Kevalam, Kalo Nasteva, Nasteva, Nasteva. He was not such a fool, because that is the only business. That is the only business. How one should develop Krishna consciousness? That is the verdict of all Vedic sastras. What is the meaning of Vedic studying Vedas? Vedaste sarvai ahameva vedam. That is the only necessity. To become educated, learned, scholar, learned in Vedas, Chaturvedi, Trivedi, Dvivedi, or Vedi, the Brahmanas were divided according to education. Ordinarily, they must study Vedas. Vedopathad bhavit vipra. Without Vedic knowledge, nobody can become a Brahmin. Vedopathad bhavit vipra. Brahma janati iti brahmana. And by Vedic knowledge, when one understands Brahma, the absolute truth, he becomes Brahman. So there are four Vedas. Sam Jajuri Kathan. Generally, they read one Veda, Sam Vedi, Rig Vedi, Jajur Vedi, Vedi. But one who studies two Vedas, he is called Dvivedi. The apabhramsha is Duve. And one who studies three Vedas, he is called Trivedi. Up-country, these titles are still there. Vedis, Dvivedis, Trivedis, and Chaturvedis or Chove. In Mathura, you'll find the Choves. But they have no connection with Vedas now, simply with the name and begging in the name of Dvivedi, Trivedi, Chaturvedi. That the purpose is how to become disentangled with this family relations, family or society, that is the increase or expansion of the same affection. So the so-called nationalism is also materialism. There is it is simply expansion. Just like you have got a party of rogues and a big party or small party, the business is plundering. That's all. Because you have got a very big party of thieves, it does not mean that you are immune from criminal activities. Therefore, these things are not required. People have become accustomed, but we discourage them. We do not approve this so-called nationalism. Therefore, we have named internationalism. Internationalism. No distinction between this nation or that nation, this religion or that religion. Religion is one. There cannot be two religions. If God is one, and what is religion? Religion means the law given by God. That is religion. This is a simple definition. What is religion? If somebody says, they will say religion means this, religion that. No. The simple definition of religion is the law of God. Dharmanta sakshat bhagavat pranita. Just like law. Law means the order given by the state. That is law. Your order is not law. Or my order is not law. But when the state orders keep to the right, you must keep your car to the right side. And the state orders that keep your car to the left side, Europe, somewhere it is right side coming left side. So, according to the state, you cannot say why sometimes it is left side, sometimes right side. No, it may be whatever it is, but because it is the state order, you have to abide by. You cannot say that I was driving my car in India to the left side, why shall I drive on the right side? Sometimes they feel inconvenience. But no, you have to, because that is the state order. But similarly, as the law means state order, similarly religion means God's order. That's all. Simple definition. Dharmantra. It is not that we have manufactured. It is stated. Dharmantra sakshat bhagavat pranitam. Nobody knows what is dharma. Neither the human being, nor the demigods, nor big sages, saintly personal, whatever you say, philosopher. No, nobody knows what is religion. Dharmasya tattanga maha nitam guhaya mahajana jena gadasya pantha. Mahajana means those who are authorized person by God, one who knows what is the law of God. He is Mahajana. So, a guru is Mahajana because he knows what is religion and what is law given by God. Therefore he is Mahajana. How he has become Mahajana? Because he is following the previous Mahajana, that's all. It is not difficult. Evaṁ parampara praptam evaṁ rājasayo vidhu. So Mahajana, therefore sampradaya. Just like we are Madhya Gaudiya sampradaya, Madhya Acharya, or Brahma sampradaya. We are following Brahma is Mahajana. There are 12 Mahajans stated in the Shastras, and Brahma is one of them. Svayambhu, Brahma's name is Svayambhu. The other day we were discussing Svayambhu. Or Atmabhu. Atmabhu. Because he is born out of the abdomen of the father. Not of the mother. Not the other. Father is the seed-giving, life-giving agent. So this life was not transferred to anyone else to take the body. The life-giver father gave him the body. Therefore, Brahma is called Svayambhu. Svayambhu, Narada, Sambhu, Kapila, Munu, Kumara, they are all Mahajans. So, dharma means the codes or the law given by God. That is dharma. And our life is meant for dharma. Dharma. But unfortunately we have created so many dharmas. But there cannot be so many dharmas. There cannot. Suppose it's gold. Gold is gold. Pure gold. There cannot be, just like they have made 20 carat gold, 14 carat gold, 16 carat gold. That is mixture. That is not pure gold. We are preaching, if you say it is religion, it is pure religion. Not correct. 14 carat religion or 20 carat religion. No. Real, pure religion. What is that pure religion? Sarvadharmān parityajya māmekam sūtam. We are teaching just surrender to Krishna. Krishna consciousness. That is pure religion. Original gold. No carat gold. Therefore, our Vrindavan Das Thakur has said very clearly, prithivite jaha kichu dharma name chole. Whatever is going on all over the world, in the name of dharma, Bhagavat kahe taha paripurna chale. According to the opinion of Srimad Bhagavatam, all this rascaldom is simply cheating. Now if we say that, everyone will be rebellious. But that is the fact. Because if dharma means the order of God, then what is God's order? That you become my devotee. Manmanabhava madbhakto madhyajimang namas. Four things. You always think of me and you become my devotee. You offer your obeisances, manmanabhava madbhakto, and worship me. So we are teaching this real religion. Here is deity, Krishna. So we are thinking of Krishna, Hare Krishna. We are worshipping deity, Krishna. There is no difference between Lord Krishna and deity. It's Krishna. And we are offering obeisances. So therefore it is real religion. Because we are strictly following the laws of God. Annavilashitam, we have no other business. So therefore, this is real religion. If you take, or real culture, real society, everything real. Because God is real. Anything in connection with God, according to His instruction, that is real. All other things are imitation. So always remember that if somebody takes us as religionist, yes, we are religionist, but pure religionist. If somebody says socialist, we are pure socialist. If somebody says we are diplomats, yes, we are pure politician. What is pure politician? Politics requires violence. So, annihilate the demands and give protection. The politics mean two things. The state, government, what is that? Government gives protection to the good citizen and those are rogues, punish them. Law and order. Two things are there. Maintenance and law and order. So similarly, our Krishna consciousness is also the same thing. But so far we are concerned because we are not in political power. Otherwise we would have followed the principles of Krishna. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has shown us the way that we kill the demons in a different way. We kill the demons in this way by chanting Hare Krishna mantra. We purify him so that his demonic activities are stopped. That is also another way of killing. He stops his demonic activities. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy, that he did not kill Jagai Madai, although he wanted to kill them, because they insulted Vaishnava. But still, Nityananda Prabhu reminded him that in this incarnation, you promised that you will not kill, so have merciful upon them. So their demonic activities were killed. That is also killed. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu accepted Jagai Madai on this condition that you have to stop your sinful activities. Whatever you have done, that is done. So we make this condition. The demonic activities, we say you have to stop. Whatever is done is done. Strictly following Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. There is no consideration. Because you are previously a demon, therefore you cannot become a Vaishnava. No. Anyone can become Vaishnava. Provided he stops his demonic activities. Anyone. Anyone is welcome. Provided he accepts this philosophy, sarva-dharmān parityajya māmekaṁ saraṇaṁ gacchami. So this is the way that Kunti is praying, snehopāsaṁ imaṁ dhiraṁ chindi. So in this way we can get rid of the so-called affection for society, friendship, love, country, nationalism, no. Our sneha, affection is completely transferred to Krishna. That is Krishna consciousness. Thank you very much.